Hey guys, I'm coming today. Going to the second episode today. The Marvel Legend review in this one, which is the Marvel's Mr. Hyde, Shang-Chi. I think there are some people say that it is Shang-Chi or Shang-Chi. So since I said Shang-Chi, I just call him Shang-Chi, I guess. But oh, and so this is their movie figure, not their comic book one, obviously. So yeah, I've rewatched Shang-Chi again. It was definitely pretty amazing. That makes me we want to get a figure of him, so I decided to pick it up. And I got it for a good deal, to be honest. I found this for a pretty nice price, so I decided why not pick it up since I found it on a good deal. Plus, it's a pretty good movie, so I decided why not pick it up. Plus, I think Marvel also announced that there is going to be a sequel for this movie, so I'm also pretty excited to see the future of him. So let's take a look at the box, I guess. So this is the build figure Marvel's Mr. Hyde. I also reviewed the other figure from this wave, which is the Tony Stark. I think it's called Tony Stark AI. We just seriously. So this is movie logo over there. So on the side we got the I think his name is Simu Liu. SDS Shang-Chi, so on the side and on the back. So this is Mr. Hyde itself. And yeah, I already reviewed the Tony Stark AI version. So I'm going to leave something like card something at the end of the video. So I'm not sure if you want to collect all of these, because most of them is definitely pretty hard to find. So yeah, most of them is it's already hard to find right now. So maybe if I found like one or two more figures from this one, we complete the Mr. Hyde. We just see. So Shang-Chi, trained since childhood by the mysterious Ten Rings organization, Shang-Chi must confront the past he thought he left behind when he is drawn back into his father's web. So that is a pretty accurate bio, I should say. So let's take a look at this accessory. It comes with a lot of interchangeable hand. Now I do have the complaint about the interchangeable hand that it comes with. I feel like most people have, which is this hand. So yeah, let's just take a look at it. I mean, it's just a normal pair of hand, but what is this, man? Why? Yeah, I don't know why Hasbro include this type of hand. Like, what is this used for? I don't know what this thing is used for. It also comes with an open hand. I mean, like a grabbing hand for the stick that it comes with, and also the open hand here. So that is a pretty good thing. But he is a kung fu character, but he didn't come with a fist, so that is a little bit on the weird side that he didn't come with any fist, which is pretty weird since in the movie we saw him like punch a lot. So yeah, that is a pretty weird one. I don't know why Hasbro didn't include a fist for this figure, but oh well, I guess. So he come with the stick here. I mean, the stick is okay, not bad. I don't know, I mean, it's definitely pretty hard to focus here. Ooh, yeah, it's definitely pretty hard to focus on. So let me just try to focus this thing on if I can. Yep, so there's the stick here, which looks pretty cool. I mean, the detail is pretty nice. So the brown color here is supposed to be represented as a dragon scale, I believe. It's what they call it in the movie. So yeah, but okay, not a bad one. I mean, I don't really like the yellow color here in the middle, but you can really see it's definitely be that to focus on. Yeah, I don't really like this gold part color, it's kinda look a little bit like bland, but oh well. So let's take a look at the figure itself, Shang-Chi. Overall, this figure is definitely pretty nice, pretty flexible. I mean, obviously you want to pose him a lot because he's a kung fu character, so he definitely have to like pose a lot. So I mean, the posability is definitely pretty good. So let's take a look at the head sculpt first. Yeah. Let me try to bring up my camera if I can, or I could just stem him up. Stem, okay. Yeah, let's take a look at the head sculpt pretty quick. So there is the Simu Liu head sculpt. I think Hasbro did a pretty good job on creating him. I could definitely see Simu Liu here. On the side, as you can see, definitely looks like him. I'm not sure if I could see him like if I look at the figure from the front here. But overall, it's definitely pretty good. I mean, it's definitely almost 100% accurate, but not really, I should say. But it's pretty accurate, I should say. Pretty nice job on the Hasbro side there. So, overall, the figure is definitely pretty, have some pretty cool, nice little detail too. So, As you can see, I think this figure has been released like before the movie came out, I believe, and it has been pretty movie accurate, as you say, overall for the figure that came out before the movie release. It's definitely pretty accurate. I feel like there are some like little detail that has been missed here and there, but still though, it is definitely overall accurate. The backflow a little bit on the plane side, Hasbro did a painting, would be pretty cool if I think this should be like a black paint on the back, but well. So yeah, looking pretty cool. So let's take a look at the side. Unfortunately, the paint here is not on the red color, so I don't know why it's not in red color here. So it would be pretty cool to get a pinless joint here, but well. So the skirt here. There's also like a skirt piece here, which kind of hinder the leg articulation a little bit, but not really much. It is a flexible material, you could still get a pretty good pose with him. So this is just a normal leg, I believe. Yeah, as you can see, the knee joint here, they could do the pinless joint on the knee, but I don't know why they couldn't do it on the arms here. I don't know why they couldn't do that, but well. So there's the sneakers, like a sneakers to me, I don't know. Like shoes and something. So yeah, this is the bottom. So let's take a look at the articulation. Like, after you, the possibility, this figure is definitely pretty flexible, as you say. So you could definitely get a pretty good range of out of this figure. So the head, you can move it up that much, move it down, turn side to side, pivot a little bit. So I don't know if you could see it. So, okay. So the hand, you can move it outward that much, turn all the way around. There's a bicep level, the double joint at these elbows, turn side to side, the waist turn side to side, hinge up and down. So the abs, you can move it forward that much, move back. There's a rotation there, the leg, you can move it forward that much, move back a little bit. So for the thigh on my figure is a little bit on the loose side, so yeah, it definitely feel loose here. This the pinless sync double joint, this knees, and come move down, up. And a copy of it. So so yeah, this is now I don't have any like Shang-Chi figure to compare him with, so I guess I'm just going to end this video. Plus my battery camera is almost finished, so yeah, this is overall it's not a bad figure. If you could still find him, I suggest that you get him. After I found this one on a good deal, so I decided to pick him up because the rewatch Shang-Chi game is definitely pretty good. So yep, and I do really want a figure of him. So that's it. If you guys enjoyed this video, you can comment, share the video to see more amazing figure reviews. So we just see what's next, and goodbye.